Hi, this is Dr. Zheng Shen. I'm professor of plastic and reconstructive surgery, and now I'll try to briefly explain you what we do in facial rejuvenation surgery. In the past, we actually do kind of surgery that we call facelift surgery, but in recent years, we use facial rejuvenation. We have, again, different tools in our hands, and just in the early days with the small deformities in the face, we use some fillers, fat injections, some thread lifts, some laser applications to the face. But in late ages with the prominent deformities of the face, we use some different surgical techniques. Face is a kind of tissue that is under the effect of gravity and some different factors such as sunlight or smoking. All those things, some genetic factors again, determine the aging process of the face. So what happens, there are some different fixed points in the face that is fixed by the ligaments, and what we face in the aging phase, there's loss of volume and sagging of the skin. The loss of volume is mainly in the mid face and the malar area, and what we see again is the marionette folds here, the folds and neck laxity, loss of volume in the neck area, and again the sagging of this tissue. To correct those deformities, we use facelift surgery, and sometimes we combine it blepharoplasty, temporal lift, or mid facelift things. Again, we choose those different techniques for each patient to give a best results to improve the facial shape of the patient. Usually in facelift surgery we use a preauricular incision, just starting from the hairline and going back to the hairline again. The scar that is will be visible just is in front of the earline, and at the end of 1 year it's almost invisible. In my professional life I haven't seen even a single patient that complains about that scar. It's red and hard, yes, in the early days, but at the end of 1 year it's almost invisible because we hide those scars just in the natural folds in front of the ear. So what we do, a skin excision is not a correct surgical technique in this kind of approach. What we do instead, we lift, elevate the skin, and then there's a kind of membrane that holds the soft tissue of the face. So we prepare this smooth layer, we call it smooth layer, a kind of membrane, and dissect it, and we lift it to the original place. Usually the direction of lift is in the vertical and posterior area, because the aging process is the vertical direction, it falls down. What we do with the smooth lift technique, we reposition the tissues that are sagging. We bring them to their original position to give the patient a good volume in the malar area, correct or improve the marionette folds here, mandibular contour lines to some extent, correct the nasolabial fold, and also if the volume loss, the fat atrophy is prominent in the patient, we sometimes use the fat injection combination with the fat injection to improve the patient's facial symmetry or shape. This surgery is a long one, and we after the surgery again we place two drains. Usually we remove those drains next day after the surgery, and the next day after we remove the drains you can have your shower freely. There will be stitches, and we remove those stitches within a week or 10 days after surgery, and we recommend some kind of, again it's very important, a garment to keep the soft tissues in place until it heals totally. Recommend some kind of, again, some sunscreens or scar healing creams to give a better scar quality at the end. And usually this surgery is very satisfying for the patient, depending on the expectations. As I told you, the result that we can get after the facelift surgery, there's not a limitation like gaining 10 years, going back to 10 years, there's not such a thing. Again, it depends on the patient's own condition. Let's say in fatty patient with lots of fat in the neck area, face area, this facelift, what we call heavy face, facelifting cannot improve the face too much. But if the sagging is too much, I mean the deformity is mainly on the skin and there's not a heavy face, then the lift of the smooth tissue and excision of the skin gives a very dramatic change. So personally, I do not recommend very fatty and heavy face a facelift surgery before she has to lose some weight, and then we can recommend that facelift surgery operation.